students, and previously I explained all the content, right? Now we will do problems based on this content, which is asked in 2020 and 2019. The question is follows here. Let A, B, C and D be four non-empty sets. A, B, C, D be four non-empty sets. The contrapositive of if A subset to B and B subset to D, then A subset to C is dash. That is the question. See, a subset meaning is what? I'll just tell you. What is set? All knows the set, right? Set is what? What is the set? The number of elements we are writing in a special bracket, like suppose natural numbers are there. 1, 2, 3. These are the natural numbers. I am making a group. So that is called a set. Okay. So every set is there. What is subset meaning? Suppose you have a set like this. B is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So every element of A is in B. Every element of A is in B. So I can say that A is subset to B. So if every element of, like here I can say that Hyderabad is there. Hyderabad is subset of what? Telangana. Hyderabad is subset to what? India. Like Maharashtra is there. Maharashtra is subset to what? India. Like you can say Kolhapur is there. So Kolhapur is subset to what? Maharashtra. Why? Because it is a part of that, right? Like same way, if A is 1, 2, 3, B is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then I can say these are part of that, so I can say that A is subset to B, right? So what I want to say here, the question is like that, if A is subset to B and B is subset to D, then A is subset to C, then what is the contrapositive of this statement, he asked. So already I explained you in the past lecture what is contrapositive. So here what is P here? P is, now you have if then, there will be conditional statement. So conditional statement, what is the P statement here? P statement is A is subset to B and B is subset to D. This is the P statement. What is the Q statement here? Then after what is there? That is the Q statement. Q is subset to C. So this is P, this is Q. So it is given conditional statement, P implies Q. So contrapositive is what? What is contrapositive? I explained you. Contrapositive is nothing but negation Q implies negation P. Is negation Q implies negation P. What is the negation Q? Is A subset to C means the negation Q will be A not subset to Q. Negation Q will be what? A is not subset to C. Now does C has given this option, which is correct. Now P is there what here? A subset to B and B subset to D. Then what is the negation of P? Negation of P will be A not subset to B, and the negation is R B not subset to C, B not subset to D. This is the negation P. P is the statement and negation P will be this. Because A not subset to B or B not subset to D. Q is this. Negation of Q will be A not subset to C. According to the contrapositive means what? Negation Q implies negation P. What is negation P here? If A not subset to C, see here, if A not subset to C, then A not subset to B, A not subset to B or B not subset to D. So this is for a negation Q implies negation P. So D is the right answer. So this is asked in January 2020 shift 1 paper. So understood? Right. Hello students, let us see. This is the question asked in 9th January 2020. All these questions are January 2020 questions. 2020, this year, January month, 2020 questions. Now this question is, what is the negation of the statement root 5 is an integer or 5 is irrational? Is asking that what is the negation of this statement, he asked. Root 5 is an integer or 5 is irrational. What is the negation? In the first lecture I told you negation is what? So let us see here. Option A, root 5 is not an integer. Correct. Root 5 is not an integer is the negation of that. You have R. R negation will be AND, but you have given R. 5 is irrational is given, means that is not a negation. So option option A is wrong. Option B, root 5 is an integer itself, but negation will be what? Root 5 is not an integer. So option B wrong. Option C, root 5 is irrational. Is irrational itself, okay? R, so option C also wrong. What is option D? Root 5 is not an integer. R plus you got and 5 is not an irrational. So this is the right option. See, this is very simple question, but JEE 2020 they asked 9th January. So this chapter is very easy to score 4 marks. Okay, hope you understand. Let us see next question here you have. What is the question here? This is also January 2020, 10th date I think. Date I did not know. So, but this is the question of January 2020. Okay, 2020 question. So, this year question. What is the question says here? The question speaks like this. What that? If P implies P and negation Q is false, P implies P and negation Q is false, then what is the truth values of P and Q? That is the options. Options are given like A, T, 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 F, like that they given. Okay, let's see here. What is this? So for this one, let us go for the truth table. Okay, now I go, how many statements are there? Two statements. So I write P, I write Q. And then I have to write under bracket, what is there here? Negation Q. Negation Q. Next, whole under bracket, that is P and negation Q. Next, what you have here? P. P already we have. So P over Q over negation Q over P and negation Q over. Then what is the P? P already we have. Then the whole thing, that is P implies. P implies P and negation Q. Now let us find the truth table of this. What is the truth table for this? Now, if you have two statements, what I have? Two, T, T, F, F. And for B, what? T, F, T, F. Negation Q is opposite of this. So T will become F, F will become T, T will become F, F will become T. Now P and negation Q. For this P and Q, negation Q, you have to do AND condition. And is what? T and T is T. Remain times false. So T F is false. T T T T F F F T F. And condition is T and T is T. Remain times it is false. Now what do you have? P and this one. Column 1, 2, 3, 4 and this is the 5. Means we are going to do column 1 and 4 implication. Implication rule is what? TF will give T, F. TF will give F, remain times false. So TF, let us say TF will give what? F. TF will give F. TT will give T. FF will give T. FF will give T. The question is said, this is false. This is false. Then what is the truth value of P and Q? So what is the truth value of P and Q? T, T. Option A is the right answer. So likewise we have to do, okay?